We are continuing our Shiurim on Otzrot Chaim. We are on Daf Lamed Gimel Amud Aleph, or Amud Beis, which is Shaar Ledat HaMochin Perek Gimel. In Rav Matuk Midvash, it's Daf Samech Aleph, in Chelek Beis. Okay, so here we go. Shaar Ledat HaMochin Perek Gimel. Now we're going to speak about Shaar Ledat HaMochin, Pshuta Kamash, we're speaking about the Ledah of the Mochim. Of Zeampin. So, now we are going to Mevaer in an Aleda, Ech Yolda Imailoa Izum. Pshuta Kamashma, we're going to speak about more in detail now about how Ima is Noilud Za. How Ima is Noilud Za. I'm just trying to see where on my notes. Okay. Here we go. Vihine. Bibiru tefilas. When we find we in biru tefilas, biru kavonas kreishim on nizbaya inyan ledas ima iloin etzun. Besod shesh tevas sheyesh beposuk shma Yisrael. Over there in shah kavonas, in shma Yisrael, pirush, the kavonas in shma Yisrael, we say the six words, the first posuk over there, there explains about the inyan of ledas mochim, ledas of the ledo of za, or zun. Ein sham heitiv shesham is bad. Okay. Besod the inner here is mekatze. He's going to tell us a little bit of the inyan in Moviyah. Vehine, vehu sod. Sorry, besod the inyan hu. Ki hine hu ki hine uzahu holid havlad notun beibul my ima shitfuna teishel chodshia ibul. We know that zun is going to be in ima for 9 months, or because Teisha Chodoshim at the end of Teisha Chodoshim Ibo as Nolad V'Yotze L'Chod. So far, no Chidushim, like a normal baby that's born after 9 months. It says the Arizal the same thing in the parts of it. The embassy is Nishtozoi. Why is it Nishtozoi? Because we learned that already the Kalim only take the Kalim take 12 months to be properly rectified. So says the. Says the Mefarshim, I think it was the Beis Lechem Yehuda that I saw, the Beis Lechem Yehuda Taka, that says, in Ahram, he's speaking about a normal Leda. That's a normal Leda that takes 9 months in our world, Olam Hazeh, but in the world of Patsuv in Taka, it takes 12 months. Right. Ve'onam, Yesh Bechinas Leda Ben Beza Atzmo, which we're talking about the Kelim Shabo, Ben Bechinas Amochim Shalo, Shel Zman Gadlus, Ken Yiskele El. Shem Bechin is Ruchnius, Vinishomas, Amochim, Deza. Veshtei Bechin is Shavas. Vekavan is Bayetz Leinu, Shetami Nichnasim, Mitlabishim, Nai de Ima. Omispashtim, Toch Za Atzmo. Ben Bechin is Zman Ibo, O Ben Bekatnashu, Zman and Yenika. ובן זמן, הגדלוס הנקרא אצלנו מוכים לגדלוס, שהוא רוכניוס, או מוכים כניסקה. Okay, so let me just explain to you, again, we've seen this in Yon many, many times, there are three stages in the growth of Zah, which is called Ibo, second stage is called Mochim, and the third stage is, sorry, so Ibo, Yenika, and Gadlus. Those are the three stages that we go through, three stages we go into the growth of Zah. Now, in all those three stages, really, Be'etzem, Ibo, Yenika happen more or less the same time. So let's call it Ibo, Yenika, and then you have, in the Patsufim, Ibo, Yenika stage, and then this is the way the Beis Lechem Yehuda explains. You have Ibo, Yenika stage, and then also you have the Gadlus stage. Now, what's going to happen is that the Ima is going to feed into Za in this process of called Ibo, Yenika. And create what's called the vak, which is za. And then later on, Ima is going to go back into za, creating what's called the gadlus of za, to create za into a position where he's attacking a gobel. Is there any nafkamina? No. The process is the exact same. The way that Ima goes into za, while he's still at Ibo and a Yenika stage, is the exact same way that Ima will go into Zah and grow Zah into a Gogol. So says Arizal, I'm not going to explain to you the Ibo Yenika stage, because it's exactly the same as the Godless stage. So he's going to explain to us the Godless stage, and there with the Dami Milsa the Milsa, we'll know how to grow Za at a stage of Ibo Yenika.
Is there something extra in the Godless stage why he does the later stage rather than the earlier?
No, it's the same. It's the same. Same process. It's the exact same process. And therefore, he's going to duplicate. Instead of telling us twice over, he's going to explain to the Godless stage, and that's going to be good enough. That's going to be that's going to explain to us what happens in the Ibo Yenika stage. So let's just revise what we spoke about. We spoke about how this process is going to be duplicated. Now, there is a fundamental problem over here, and that is, if we think about it, that in the stage of Ibo, by definition, Ibo meaning that the child's still in the mother's stomach. Okay, that means the child, which we're talking about, is Zah here, and Ima is the Ima, parts of Ima. Now, Bishlama, when he's a Godel, we can understand there's a pasuk called Zah. We can understand there's Ima coming in. She's mispasha to Nahi into Zah in order to create and give him more Shefa. But in the Ibo stage, where the Ibo is still inside the mother, how's a child that say that the mother's giving over her Nahi into Zah when the Ibo itself is cooler inside of Ima? That's the kasha, Shaul Dweck, he's asking. So he answers, is that Anachanami, there's two dinim. Shnei dinim. One dinim is takia, that when Zah is born, the Or of Ima will be Or in Kelim of Ima, or Machnis themselves into Zah to grow Zah. Mitzad Acher, there's another din, while Zah is still in the mother, then it's not shy to say the Ima's Nahi goes into her. But rather, we're talking about the Ha'ora. He says the Ha'ora of Ima then is mispashit menubein tzadifer into Zah. Into Zah. Yeah. Sorry, it's not the Eshel, it's actually the base Lechem Yehuda. Actually, the pereck base. Okay, so let's continue now. Now, hinei maschi levaya, says Arizal. I'm going to start explaining to you the inyan here. Beginners, latest mochim the gadlus is Zah. Again, we're explaining when Zah is already a godel, not a godel, he's going to become a godel, and this inyan of ima being machnis into, it's called mochim the gadlus into Zah. Shu beginners ruchnius nishmasam kiniske. Shefa. Spiritual shefa into Zah. Or we manage the Ba'alicha lay the Zah atzmo mamash hakol echad. Like we said, the two previous stages of Ibo Yenika is identical to what we're going to explain here. Now let's start with that. Kinei apostuk omer, the apostuk in Shmois Aleph Tezayin. It says like this. Ve'yome ve'yaledchem. You know, the power spoke to Miriam and to his daughter, and he said to them, "You are you helping the Israeli women to give birth?" And he says to them, "You have to kill them when they're giving birth." So says Chazal is talking. It's a Gemara and Soita Daf Yud Aleph on the base. It says, Ki avnayim hem ayerchaim shel isha. What's avnayim mean? What's pshat? We don't know what's pshat. Pshat is, says Chazal, those are the thighs of the women. Kasher yoledes mitzantzanim mitztanenim umitzkashim kmo avonim avnayim. Malachem nikraim avonim. That when they're giving birth, the thighs harden up in order to allow this process to happen, and they're called taka rocks. We're going to explain more to depth now. We know there are many oilers in Ima Ilan, Ali de Ibo Ze, and Niska Le'el. Vavlad Wazar Rotzelet Lovid, Lihit Valid, Viliot Pi Rachman Tsar, And since the we're talking about the lot of oilers in Ima, Zaz also inside the stomach of Ima, and that's also oilers. For the Baal Taka, there's so much oil over there. Therefore, the Vlad can't get out because the Rechem is too small. But when the Zman HaLeida comes starts, the Nigman Zman Ibo, then the whole Inyan of Ibo, the Zman Ibo has finished. Kavan Nitkan Yistaira Ibo, as the Bechilas Orod Varuchnius Sheyesh Benayi Ima Mistalkim Misham. Olim lemale beguf ima atzma bemokam ha'ubo ha'omed sham bebechines ibo az mitrabim sham ha'orod v'hine yesh sham or shel tiferetz atzmo de'ima v'ha'orod shel ha'machatzit haguf ha'tachton shela k'niska v'kol ha'orod z'zun sh'omdim sham besod ha'ibo v'az ha'beten shela yechola lispo ein ha'beten yechola לסבול כל ריבו האורד הם, אז ואז האורד שלו בחינה סיימה עצמה שהיא בלס בייס, דוחים את האורד הזון שאין הנשלה, ושהם אורח ומוציאים אותם לחוץ דרפי היסוד שלה, ונבקע ונפתח רחמה ויוצא לזון לחור. So what happened over here? So what happens in the order telling you the sod of later, what's the sod of later? The sod of later's pshat is that the nahi of ima, retracts, goes back up into her tiferes, and since there's a ribu of oil, remember she has her oil over there. Za is also oilless, it's also over there. She, by the fact she's retracting her nahi back inside of that mokum, that's merabe oil, and pushes out the vlad. That's the way it works. That's the ganze inyan. אורז רוחד מזמן משמע סטאלקי משם אויל למעל בקוב אימא עצמא במקום שאיבו שם and then is rab im euros and that's take pushes down za out nimsa זאת אריזה שאליאס ויסטאלקוס אוז נאי שלום מת למעל the fact that her nai is going back up the oil going back up who לשני תועלת them is two תועלסים that's happening on the day that the nahi of ima goes back up Echa the Torah Vlad, which we just explained. The Leda will help, that process will help to push the baby out. Shalidei aliyas aliyasa mitrabim shama orot, v'dochim et ha'uba motzim otu nevuchut. V'asheni, what's the other toilets? The other toilets is the Torah Mochim deza, kimuvan tzleinu, she'enu nechnasim deza, ela ache heyoiz, meluva shebinai de'ima, v'lechein hutzroch lihidroken מהמאורות שלהם כדי שיקנסו במוק המאורות המוקים דזה כי שני בחין הזה אורות שלה ושל זה אי אפשר להיות ביחד מי זה נגיד? There's two to L is the fact that the nai of Ima is coming up first of all it's pushing the vlad out the second to L is what? Is that by her emptying out her nahi right? There's two dinim over here one din is that there's kelim and there's all In the Nahi of Ima, that means the Kelim of Ima, there's oilers. She's Mali the oilers on it, means wiping out all oil from her Nahi. And that, there's a Tuelis, not only the fact that the oil is going to come back and push the child out, but Zah is going to use that empty Kelim of Nahi, Netzahod Yisod of Ima, in order to create himself. That's the Taka the Yisod. V'hine, kasher olim itztalkim o'oz menai de ima hem olim. What's going to happen now? The fact that her oil again is repeating himself. Some stalik ima hem oiling. All mibachati al tachton shel tiferes de ima atzmo. They go up until the halfway of the tiferes. Asher sham hu mamad za besod ibo. Ibo is still there. Again, he's repeating himself. V'dochim et oiso motzim osel chut. He pushes that oil will push now za outside of her. Im kein nimso shiesh om di tachat moko machaze de ima. Therefore, it's found out. It comes out that shehem omdim tachat mokom machazed ima shesham omdim shtei dadim shel isha. All the oilers are going to be in that mokom in the chazed of ima. And you know what else is going to happen? The amazing feat is going to happen. Shesham omdim shtei dadim shel isha. Those were the dadim of the isha created. Shehari hem oisim to el slishis valiasim lemala. Ki az nitosav ha'aro gedoyla ve'achaz ebolotim oisav ha'aro techutz. The fact that the hanai is coming out is going to another toel. It's the fact that the dodim are going to come up protruding from the ima. Nasim b'mokom ha'chazik ki ein shtei dodim v'nifka'im u'mem yotza cholav le'eni ketzer'u v'acher alida. V'zehi esiv ha'tam lama ein ish b'chinas blitas ha'dodim kimo shiesh b'ish. That's why a man doesn't have dodim, because he doesn't have this inyan of the leida. The hinder, the nai of the all the nai coming up, being boiled out from the chest. V'hine ze nirgash b'chush orod, shebitekev acher leida zav, acholo v'yotze de'ar dadim. And that's that we see that b'chush, the woman after leida, straight away the dadim attacking flowing with cholov. Ma she'en ge b'tchilosa, ma she'en before that, there was no. And that's taka proving the system. V'hine note she'acholov hu dam b'tchila, that's taka was dam b'tchila. She'haya omid l'mata b'rechem shelam, v'ala misham ad ha'mokom ha'dadim. ונפח לחלב על ידי עליאס אלו האורות נזכרם שם ונמל לגורם נפח לחלב. He didn't explain exactly how this happens, not here anyways. In a different mockum it does explain. But he's saying that another toalis is that not only that it's going to create the dadim, it's going to create the cholov. How does it create the cholov? The fact that it's going to be male, the dam, and through the dam it's going to create taka this union of cholov. Let's go right there. ובזה יובל מה שאומר בחזר, the Gemara says, תק and ברוך, זו שם לגימו למודע, עמוד בייס. על הפוסוג, זוי סטוירה, I'm just adding a few words, זוי סטוירה, אודם כי יומוס בועל, that's what I state in the פוסוג. A person who, זוי סטוירה, אודם הוא יומוס, it's someone who dies in the oil. Talking about Tumah Vatara. But the Gemara attack in Brochus of Samar Gimel Amud Beis brings down a deal called Resh Lakish. Amar Resh Lakish, Eina Torah Mitzkayemes, Ela Bisha Bimis Atzmo Aleha. Yeah? So that's a Pipshan. A Pipshan, the Pshat in the Pasuk is, what does it mean, Zoyis the Torah, Odom Ki Yomus Bo'oilom? Says Resh Lakish, someone who taka is a Baal Torah. Torah is only Mekayemes, somebody taki really works at it. Somebody who really works at it, attack it, and then Torah is Mekayemes. That's the drush apipshat. Apisod, what's pshat? Ki Torah hi zah be'atzmo. The Torah is connected zah. Kenode hu nikra Torah shebal peh. And nukva is connected Torah shebechtav. Va'kiyum, sorry, forget. Zah is connected Torah shebechtav. And nukva is connected Torah shebal peh. Now, va'kiyum shelo hem ha'mochim. Now, he can only exist if he has mochim. Ben Torah yechol iskayim, that the Torah yechol, the ein the Torah yechol iskayim, the Torah yechol mochim iskayim, the Torah yechol, that means Zah needs Torah in order to mekayim himself, that he needs mochim. That's the way he can mekayim. Zah is connected to the Torah. Ele alidei bina hanikra mi. Bina is mi. Why mi? Because mi, the matra of mi is 40 and 10 is 9, 50. That's the Nun Shar Bina. That's the Remez to Bina. She may miss Atzma. When she, Bina, is may miss Atzma, Bishvila Torah, which is Zah, that means Shanai Shala Mistalkim Oil Shala, Nisharim Kemesim Kelim Bilti Atzmus, Voguf Bli Guf, Neshama, Oisim Ke Bishvila Torah, Shua Zah, Kedeshi Labishu Betorah Mochim Shalo, Vehem Mochim Shalo, Vein Likamah Mitlabishu, Vehitlabishu Ze Ma Inyono. So what's Pshat the Pasuk? The Pasuk is, again, Nachamol, Zois HaTorah Mi Sheyamus Bo'oil, Ein HaTorah Miskayemes, Ela B'mi Shememis Atzmo. What does that mean? Apisod Resh Lakish was teaching us, Yesod Godo, that the Torah is taket, Torah is Zah. Miskayemes is only Alidei Mi Shememis Atzmo. That means, Alidei, that imas may miss asmas, that means she's a salika off from her nahi, therefore the Torah is mekayemes, that means zan is mekayemes. The Kerem Shlom and Ois Dalet, Adzin, I'll just read you the Lashon, we have here, mechanikan zah be'erech nukva, k'mo shkotuv ein Torah mitz mekayemes, haynu al shem shu mikabel shefa. Because the interesting diuk over here, because the emes is that Resh Lakish is Ein HaTorah Miskayemes Beloshen Nekeva, feminine. And then he says Ela Mimisha Memis Atzmo Beloshen Zocher. Should be forget, because if Torah is Zah, Shavi en miskayim. And if mi means ima, then the loshon should be mi means atzma, not atzmo. It seems to be faket. Zai is referred to as a feminine, and ima is referred to as a masculine. So says the Kerem Shalom, the pshat is that vibad zai is betos mekabel, and ima is betos mashpia. That's why she's called the zocha, and that's why he's called a mekabel. That's pshat, because mekabel usually b'derechla is a mekabel. Let's continue. Weiter. Gamz is saw the pasuk, another pasuk. By the way, he's going to give three reasons why the pasuk says avnayim. The first pshat is like this: Vayomer, the pasuk says Vayomer vayaletchem reitem vareisem al avnayim. That's what the pasuk says. Vini ve'eis zman aleda mistalkim oz va'yerchochem ayerachaim shel isha. The taka, all the oils come out from the woman's legs. Shem netzar hod shela. You know, the right leg is netzar and the left leg is hod. Nishorim karim yeveshim kavonim, kemo yerche adam b'moisa. That's like a person dying stack is like a rock. Sha'oriz mitorcha shu nishama hu kemo esh. Because a nishama b'torcha person is like the ish keeps him alive and warms him up. Ner, like the pasuk says, besod, ner Hashem nishmas adam. Ner, which is fire. That's why it keeps the warmth in the person's body, because there's a burning flame inside. That's what the pasuk means. Avnayim means avonim. Why? Because she's taka getting out all her neshama in her legs. That's why it becomes like rocks. That's one pshat. Another pshat in avnayim means gam hu litav acher kenod besefer zomer tikurim shachagat nikraim avos. Chesed gvura and tiferet and zoaz referred to the gimel office. The nayim netzar yosod is always referred to the bonim. Lachen nikraim avnayim loshen bonim. You got it? That's why it says taka the loshen alaveis nun yud mem avnayim in the pasuk, referring to the bonim, because that's where the bonim come out from the nayim. And the third pshat, tam shlishi, that the tam shlishi kia nayi shela hem chozim lasus bechinas guf atzmo lezu. Another pshat in bonim is that become bonim b'fnei atzmo, completely new entity. Very good. With that, we're messiahim shah ledus of Mochim pereck gimel. Baruch Hashem. Now we're going to move on to the next shah Mochim. Shah Mochim pereck aleph. Nevar ata inan itlabishus Mochim dezar toch hakelim denai deima. Now what we're going to speak about now. We're going to talk about the mochim of Zah betoch hakelim denai deima. The hain like this, as follows. Let me just read one more. Laim shenishar rekenim be'esa leida keniske le'el kedei she'achakach yeh mispashtim betoch Zah. It means like this. We just saw now that the nahi has oiros inside it, right? The nahi, the netzah hod yesod of ima, has oiros inside her kelim. Now what's happening? They're vacating. The oil is vacating her nahi and leaving empty kelim. Now what's going to happen to these empty kelim? I'll tell you exactly what's happening. The mochim of Zah are coming from outside the act. They're coming from the high bechinas. They're going to come down into these empty kelim of Netzach Hod Yosod of Ima, and that package deal is going to come into Zah. Okay, that's called the tipa. It's got a sign on the side of Abba, which he doesn't speak about here, because it's nichlal in Ima. That's what we don't speak about. It's maluvish. But what we see is actually the tipa of Ima, the tipa, which is technically called the kelim of Netzach Hod Yosod. Inside of that, it's going to have the mochim of Zah, which are coming from outside the Ak. They're going to come in, and they're going to come into Zah. That's what this peg is going to speak about.
Where is it? What's the tipa again?
The tipa, I told you, the kelim, the ima, which have been vacated, they're empty. And what's going to come in that? The mochim from on high. And then all of that, those two bechinas are going to be machnis into the chabad.
So which days does it become a tipa?
Huh?
Which stage does become a tipper?
When it's time to be moily this godless. Mochim the godless. When it's time to bring in the, which we haven't learned yet, when it's that time to bring the godless of Zah inside into him, Mochim the godless, that's when the tipper is going to come inside.
So even though it entered in Samech, it's not a tipa yet.
It hasn't entered yet. It's a tipa even before it entered, yes. The tipa creates that. Like a child is created through a tipa of ima. Right? There's a tipa of Abba, tipa of ima. The connection together creates the evil. Same thing we think of here. Except this is a different type of concept, I'm asking, because the Zah is already created. Zah is already created. So there's a new spiritual type of tipa which is going to go. This is sort of the intellect that you instruct your child with, you teach your child, that's called a tipa. You're transferring what you know into him, that's called a tipa, transference. Tchila nevai b'chin is ima atzmo. First, let's discuss ima first. She'iev sha she'tisha al-chaseo now. Now, this is a misnomer. If we actually think that her netzah hod yisod is being vacated and she's left without any legs, I mean, she's giving the legs to Zah, that's not the pshat, says Arizal straight away. That cannot be. Because we know a rule, first of all, whatever's happening in this world is happening in the next world, in the spiritual world. And since we know that a woman gives birth, doesn't give over her legs over to the child, that doesn't make sense. We know that's not the matias, so what do we mean by the netzah hod yisod giving over? She's giving over her netzav hod yisod into Zah. What does that mean? It can't be that she's giving over her legs and she's left legless. That's a word. That can't be the pshat. Because if she's given over right and left leg and her yisod hashkiz mizavik with Abba, she'arin no, then we know ki as zivug of the Abba of Ima tal divelo pesik v'il almin. We know the Zohar tells us that the zivug Abba of Ima are on a constant basis. But the sibah is muchachu sheyidya v'ila naya cherim chadosh letzorach atzma b'chazakirim. A new musik. New musik. It can't be she's left without a nahi. Can't be. Elamai, she must be developing, she must have developed a new nahi. A new nahi. Very important concept. It's called the nahi chadoshi. She'a'ol she'la'em keval bi'alnu. She is alu ba'atzma, v'lum t'lam she'vizam. Her own oirus that were in the netzachot yusud go up and go back into it, doesn't go into zam b'chlam. As t'ye'ima shlema b'kol eses firus. We'll see how this works exactly. So we'll see your netzach hod yisod goes up, and b'sach hakol you have 10 oiros inside. So be'etzim she's mushlam, except she doesn't have the kerim. Now how are the kerim going to come out? That's what we're going to speak about now. Omnam in chadush havaya is nai chadosh. We're talking about the kerim now. Le'ima hu be'ofen zeh. It's exactly what we've been saying. Her kelim are vacated, and his all, which is coming from Lemala, coming back into her kelim, back into Zah. אבל רוחניות נשמה זו נהי שדאימא שהם האורס בתוכה, but the oil which is inside of it לא נשאר בהם. They don't stay, they go up at the אימא, they stay in them. אומנם, הסתלקו למעלה בעם זה בתוך חצי תפארת, חצי התחנות תפארת, דאימא כנזכר לעד, they go up into her שליש אמסוי. ואז הרוחניות והאורס הם מזהבים וממצים כלים אחרים דנאי לצורך עצמה. So what's going to happen through the fact that it's going up, it's going to create this cooker pressure situation, and this or is going to create the kelim הזה. ואז נשלמת אימא ועשר ספירות גמורות מלבד דנאי שנתלבשו בתוך זה. So there's going to be two nais the אימא. One nai the אימא is going to go into זה במשלים him. And another, and nai the ima is going to be created through the fact that all is going to create this situation. We're going to explain more in the detail now. Upashtutu she'ein koach ba'oros ahem lehamtzia havayas kelim acher lechadosh negamai. It can't be that they all create kelim in Gansin. So let's see how it works. Omna, hu alder zeh hagdolas hakoten v'holech v'god. It goes, works slowly. V'chein b'kan, הלבוש דאימא, רוצה לא אומר, בכינס כלים שבה נשאר בחצב קיום למעלה, ולא נכנס בזה, הוא נגדל ונריך עד הולך ומחסר מלביש את האורות עצמות ורוכנס דנאי דזהב, דאימא. ואם כן, צור שיגדל כפליים מה שהיה כדי שיפסיק לזה. Let's keep on reading. It's going to explain more and more muzba as we go along, because we're going to see the oil is going to go up and create double amount of kalim. Then once there's double amount of kalim, then they're going to come back down, and that's going to be mashlim the kalim, the missing netzah hod yisod, and also the malchus of ima and the yisod, right? Netzah hod yisod, and then the malchus. Let's continue. V'hine zeh kiflosom. Hine za ein lokach me kelim shel ima rak bitkhila shlish tachton de tifera shel ima velemat. What does that exactly take? We speak about it takes about the night, but it really takes a bit more than the night. It takes the lowest part. Remember, we split the tiferes into three parts, right? We always do that. It's part of one of the biggest spheres that we have, and the lowest chelik shlish tachton of the tiferes is going to be taken from Zah, and the Netzach Hod Yisod. Ima Netzach Hod Yisod, Umalchud Sheba, and also it's going to take the Malchus of Ima. Kimo Sheba Adzat Hashem. V'nimza, ki ma shenichna b'Zah, him Arba Midas, he calls Sphiros Midas, same thing. Arba Midas Shlish, what are the four Midas he takes again? Netzach Hod Yisod, Malchus, four spheres, and a third Shlish, which is the Shlish Tachton of Tiferes. So therefore, since we're missing four and a third, we're going to need four and a third. How is it going to count? Ketzad naschil. How would he start counting? Metzchilos shnei shlishim achronim shiyesh bebina de'ima. So let's think about it. Now we have esesferos in Zah. We have chokma, bina, das, and we have the rest. Now, we're going to have to double, we're going to need at least four spheres and a third in order to be mashlim ima. She's missing four spheres and a third. Now, what are we going to double? We're going to double up the two shnei shlish tachtone debina. We're going to double chesed. We're going to double what else? We're going to double bina. Sorry. Shnei shlish debina. And he's going to spell it out. Let's read it inside. Shem shlish midos shlemas. That means the two shlishim, shnei shlish of bina, achroinim, the two lashlishim, nimna sheyu arba midos shlish. That comes out. You have four and a third. Why do you have four and a third? Well, think about it. Every pereck split into three. So chokma, you have three chalakim. Bina of three. Das, you have three. Chesed, and so on and so forth. You have three parkim in every single sphere. Now, when you look at Bina, Bina's three parts. Look at the last two parts. Double that. That means you have four parts. How many chalokim it takes to make a sphere? Three parts. So how many parts you have all together in Bina? You have all three of the original chalik of Bina, plus another two, that's five parts. That's one sphere and a third. Right? Because every sphere is three, and you have an extra two. So you have one sphere and a third. Nimna elio arba midos vishlish. Shehem, excuse me, one sphere and two thirds. So let's start again. Ketza nashil. Metchila shnei shlishim achroinim shiyesh bibina de'ima. Nimna viyiyu arba midos vishlish. It's going to explain himself. Shehem, shlosha midos shlemas. So what do we have now? We have das, we're going to make a double of das. Chesed, a double of chesed. Gvura, we're going to double a gvura as well. So we're going to have all those three bechinas doubled. As we go along. So far, we have three. Vishnei shlim tachtoinim shel bina de'ima, plus those two bechinas, shnei shlim tachtoinim de'ibina. And also we're going to double the two lower parts, shneishlish elyon shitiveres the ima, hem arba midos vishlish. We're going to have all together four and a third. Ve'elu nigdulun v'nichpulu k'flai v'nasi shmona midos v'shnei shlishim. Means like this. If we look at the picture, what do we have? We have, let's talk about the spheres were shlemes. We have das, we doubled. We have three chalakim over there, which makes one sphere. We have three chalakim of chesed, which makes three spheres. We make three chalakim of gvul, which makes, therefore, in total, three spheres. Then we have two up in Bina and two up in Tiferes, the two-thirds which are there. So altogether, we have four spheres and a third. That's exactly what was missing, and that's exactly what we want. Now, if you count them all up, really, Be'etzim, you have eight altogether. Why eight? Because you have to count three in Chochmah. Remember, three Chalakim over there. So you have three in Chochmah, three in Bina, three in Das, three in Chesed, three in Gevurah, and two in Tiferes. Because one-third of Tiferes you gave away. that makes eight and two-thirds altogether. Let's count that again. So you have three, three, three. That's nine, ten, and ten and a third. That's when you count them all together, you have ten shlemes. Shehem, he spells them out. Shem shnei shlishim tachtonim debina. That's two. V'das v'chesed gvur tiferet netzahod yosod malchus shebi'ima. That's all together. V'haren nishlemu al yedei, you have to add in al yedei chochmah, the three chalakim of chochmah, elyon, and the shlish elyon. Together with that attack, you're gonna have all ten. So without chochmah and the shlish elyon of bina, you're gonna have eight spheres altogether. That's including the kefil, and altogether with the chochmah and the shlish elyon, you're gonna have ten altogether. He's asking a question over here. V'im toma lama nichnas b'tchilas za. Bichina shnei shlishim tachtonim de tiferes de ima lemata. As nimso lama lo. So I missed out an important word. Lama lo, because we know that za's keser is malbish over the shlish tachton of ima. But why did we have it that the keser of za is malbish the shnei shlish tachton of za of ima? Because in that way you would have. He's going to explain right now. Let's read the words inside. V'im toma, lau lo nichnas b'tchilat zah b'b'chin shnei shlishim tachtonim de tiferes de ima de limata. As, what would be the benefit in doing that? As nimsu arba midos v'shnei shlish would have, what? Four midos means four spheres and two shlishim. Two shlishim. V'az haita shel b'chinas bina de ima nichpeles v'nigdeles. Shemitchila bina de ima at siyum shlish rishon the tiferes the ima hem arba midos bina das. Let's count them. You have bina das chesed v'gvura ve'od shlish elyon the tiferes. But what would happen? Because if you increase the zaz yenika, that means zaz chesed will be on the shnei shlish. That means you need to be machbil bit more. That means the entire bina would need now to be doubled over. Because what do we have now? We have only the shnei shlish of the tachta of the bina. But if you increase in za lemala, that means bina completely have to be nichbal. So why wasn't it that way? By the way, that's the way we find nukva. Nukva is on the shnei shlish tachtonin of the yisod za. And Mashiachim, when we have za is only on the shlish tachton. So the question is, why is that? Why can't we have a completely kefil of bina? Bina das v'guva. V'od shlish eli on the tiferes. V'hayu nichpolim u'maspikim. U'maspikim. Aval ata she'ene kesed za ole lemala mishlish tachton the tiferes ima nimsa shalo nichpola kol bina.
Why is it that we only have a kefil of the two lower chalokim of bina and not all three?
So what is the answer? The tshuva here. Kida v'akdoma, you should know this akdoma. Kida akdoma achas. V'hi ki kemoshin is by ki zivug abba v'ima shem v'chinas shnei partzufim. You know abba v'ima two partzufim. Shnei mebechines chokhma bina, the Abba v'ima comes chokhma bina, the klolos olam atzilos. Lihiyos nechshav kulo parts of echad kenizka behava mekomes. Vihine zivugam tadir velo pastik almin. Vegam keechad inon nafkin vekechada inon sharin. It's lashon zohar. They're always completely together. Abba vim always completely together. Ve'en hevesh beneihem. Ki ima gdola ke'abba. They're the same size. They're completely in a constant zman of zivug. וזהו טעם דזווי גאי הוא תדיר, מה שאין כן בזון שאין זווי גאי הוא תדיר, לפי שנוק לפעמים גרוע וחסר ממנו ואין לו שווים, ואז אין הוא יכול להזדבק אימא. מה שאין כן בזון, נוק וסמטיים זה שווה בשווה, סמטיים שהיא סמולה, אין סון סופה. והיא, כן אינה בכל הבחינס חוכמה בינה, אין איתה מפענה חוכמה בינה, זה אוי זה סיים, חוכמה זה אוי זה סיים, אז בינה. פרט שיש בכל פרצוף, ופרצוף שניהם שווים במציאותיהם. וזבירום תדיר, he's repeating himself, אם כן נמצא של חוכמה בינה, פחותים שבעשר ספירות דאימה, צריכים שיהיו שווה במציאותיהם, שיהיו זבירום תדיר. Since the clause is that the זבירום תדיר, the אמבה ואימה has to be constant, that means they have to be the exact same size, ולכן, אם זה לוקח מאימה שתי שלישים, התחתונים, the תפארת שלה, if זה would grow up to the שני שליש תחתונים of יסוד דאימה, that means היית צריך כל בינה דאימה להתגדר בכפל וכולה, that means all of Bina would need to be mitzkapel herself to increase double size. Bezevada yesh bo tashus kocha that would weaken Bina. Ma she'en ken b'chokma she'nishma kol kocha ba. Ma she'en chokma which is not affected by this kefil. Lo huchbo lo lashkem b'chaser b'chinas aicheres b'shtechteya. Ma she'en ken b'bina b'chatzi kocha nitam b'toch tona. Therefore, Ima would reduce the strength to half. That's the reason why Zah cannot increase more than Ashlish Tachton, the Tiferes, in order that Bina shouldn't have to increase, use up more of a Korah. And that's why Bina shouldn't have to increase, use up more of a Korah. So that means the Shlish Elyon our Bina stays by itself. It doesn't have to be weaken herself in order to make herself weaken herself. Only the two bottom parts of the Ima weaken herself, but that doesn't affect, apparently, this doesn't affect the relationship between Abba and Ima. They can still mazav. And the question is, why not? Two-thirds are being weakened at the end of the day. Why? What would make a difference if there's a third not there? Bira ininu. Shehine Bina Hitzur Zahei Burishona Shabeshem Kenodam. Vitzur Zahei He Shloshit Kavim. We know the Hei is like this. Kiyur Kolalim Kol Eses Sfios. It includes all 10 Sfios. Kavim Yamin Kolal Chochma Vechesed and Netzach Sheba. Kavim Smoli Kolal Bina Vigvur Shehod Sheba. Kavim Say Kolal Kesev Kavim Tzor, which is the top part of the Hei. Kolal Kesev Das Tifer Yesod Machol Sheba. Hine, Shlisha Elyon Sheba, which is the Bina, Hem Chabad Sheba. That means like this. You can take every sphere and split it into 10 spheres. When you look at the top three spheres, for example, Bina, let's take the sphere of Bina, split into 10 spheres, because every sphere splits into 10. The top three is Chabad. That means a third of Bina is Chabad, is the Ika strength of the whole Bechina of Bina. You do that with all of his spheres as well. Shehem shlosha rashim shel shlosha kavim sheba. Vehem shlosha rishona sheba. Vekivam she'elu kaimim bekol kocha b'shlemus maspik bezeh. He tells you, why is it that just having a shlish of bina is good enough? Because you know why? Because that's the top, that's the most important part, because that includes the chokhma bina dat av bina. Shekivah shlosha rishona sheba b'shlemus. וגם כיוון ששלוש הראש הקווים ניכורים בשלי מוסם, אין צור לתשלום, אין תשלום בכלל. ופחד במוקום מוכח שיוכפלו מטעם הנזכר. And therefore, in this inner, נפקא מינה, the kefil, even though the kefil, the two bottom חלוקים of bina, but that doesn't affect it. All time אחר, קורא לנזכר לאל, והוא כשלוש הראשונס, לעולם העם חשוב כאחס. They are ממש one shtick. ואם כל בינה דאימא הייתה נכפלת ותשע שכוחה, נמצא שאין לה השוואה כשתי ראשונות. She wouldn't be like, we have כסר, which is שולם. We have חוכמה, which is שולם. Mamash Enkin, if all of Bino would not be Shalom, that means Nichpolo Bichinotea, and therefore Machli Shakoach, she wouldn't be on the same level Kesel Chochma. Lachin Hutzel Sheaniach, Mimeno Shlish Echad, Shalom Yutashkoach, she had to leave a Bichin, which is not Muchpola, Be'erze Yech Hashuvuske Achaz Mirishon. And therefore, with that Bichin Ashtake, she is safe to be considered to be part of Kesel Vachochma. Okay. Good, so we'll Messiah over here. Mitzvah Hashem, next time we'll meet, we'll start Perek Beis of Shavuot. Shkoyach.